Gracias. when I was going through this whole sale thing, maybe I was a little edgy because of the girl, you know.
You would be. I don't know. But yeah, just slip me a couple of bucks on the side. You wake up at 6:30 or so, you jerk off, then you go down, I assume, and eat breakfast before you take your shower, right?
Yeah.
What do you have for breakfast?
Sloppy noodle of cat at 3 on the Pete Lolita.
That was Ronnie Mund.
Brand, okay.
That's correct.
I didn't know they made trumpets Westinghouse brand. Okay.
And it's a unique item. My son actually
is setting the highest standards for ingredients.
It's totally up to you. And whatever.
Send them back for a full refund. An organic cotton. Think it's
oops. And you have to figure out what kind of food you have.
Right.
And they don't use the word.
I've got to get it together.
Good morning, you're on the swap shop.
Good morning, Ron. How are you today?
Some of the amazing upcoming meals are sick. So don't wait. Blue apron.
I got you beat there.
All right. So who's this?
This is Gary. I have a trumpet I'd like to sell.
Trumpet? Okay, Gary.
Yep, and
hold on a second. Trumpet?
Westinghouse trumpet.
Oh, Westinghouse brand. Okay.
That's correct.
I didn't know they made trumpets Westinghouse brand. Okay.
And it's a unique item. My son actually plays it himself.
All right. Well, how much?
Gary, just play the trumpet one time for Ron.
All right. Okay, Gary, I'm about ready to turn this off, all right? Well, I don't know how that call got through, but it got through. But anyway, sorry about that, folks. When it starts to become obscene, then that's the time we cut it off. All right, let's go back to the phone. Good morning. You're on the swap shop. Sorry to keep you waiting. So it's going to be one of those days, folks. Well, all right. If that's the way you want to play, okay. Back to the phone. Good morning. You're on the swap shop. You know what? I have a question up. I have a question for you. Listen up. You there? Are you there? Listen up. All right, okay. You don't want to answer. All right, anyway. So when you're dealing with people with the mentality of an 8-year-old, that's what you get.
I got the this pair of jeans on today. They look good on me and everything, but they got the fucking button-down fly, and I hate it. I hate the button-down fly. Who invented that? Like, what? And it's not even like it's stylish or something. No one sees your button-down fly. Nobody. Why would they have that? Especially for a guy in radio. I'm trying to get out of the bathroom there. I'm standing there, buttoning. Forever. Good Lord. Ooh, I can't get them. I love John Barbados pants. And most of them have zippers. But some of them, they have button-down fly. And it drives me nuts that they made a button-down fly. In other words, it's not like it's buttons on the sides of your pants where people can see it. You understand what I'm saying? Why would they do that? It takes so long to get back into action.
I hear ya.
I mean, what is this, 1817? What are we living during, what, the Civil War? I can see they had button-down fly then, because they hadn't invented a zipper yet, I guess. But it's I can't comprehend it. It's incomprehensible to me that they would invent that. Why not put a combination lock on your fly? So we could sit there and fiddle with it. Make up a code. Unbelievable. Let's go to, who's on the phone here? Oh my God, the phones are packed. We should get to some of them. Let's go to Chris. Chris, you're on the air. Welcome to Monday, Chris.
Hey, good morning, Howard. How are you doing, man?
You have button-down fly? I fucking hate it.
I never could ever fucking do that.
I'm standing in the bathroom. I said, you know, I'm ready to go back on the air, but I'm standing there buttoning each. Maybe I should churn my own butter. Like, that's literally how backward I think it is. I'm going to ask him. I know John Barbados personally. I'm going to ask him, why would you use button-down fly?
Well, you don't have to buy them, Howard.
I bought them because they look good on me, these pants, but they would look just as good on me with a zipper.
They don't come with a zipper?
No. That's what I'm telling you. Certain styles he has are only button-down.
Huh.
And I don't know why anyone would want that. It's so fucking annoying. Especially, I have a cut on my fingertip.
Oh, so that makes it even harder.
More annoying. Yes, Chris.
All right, so Howard, first of all, I got to say, that past hour, stock went down in serious after that conversation about me jerking off.
Why would it go down? People love to hear about me jerking.
Oh, that was pretty fucking gross, man.
Really? I was so entertained.
I don't think I'm ever going to get a hard on.
I find that compelling. You know, I drive around in my car. I do kind of quality checks on the show to see if I'm on my game. And I was driving around. I was listening to Charlize Theron. I'm Theron. I was listening.
What I'm calling for.
What are you calling for?
I'm calling about that interview right there. That had to be one of your greatest interviews. Is she the sexiest woman that has ever walked the face of this?
There's levels of problems, and I've got major fuck. Go twice a week, and you know, listen.
Oh, you down there two times?
Yeah, it's been that way. I know. I started like making out with her. It was not in the script, by the way. I started making out with her and putting my hands on her tip. And certainly then a television commentator and a movie star. I mean, he had it all going on.
And a spokesperson.
I mean, they did the right thing technically. We do have laws, and most guys who did what O.J. did, or at least what he got locked up for, would not even have done 9 years. So they kept him in there. I chopped off Nicole's head and put it in the collection plate.
Do you think on October 2nd,
stay
mad at the windows were open and the doors were open?
OJ. Robert Kardashian.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Man, it's been a few long years, but I've been fantasizing about a few people, especially Robin,
what about it? Would you go with OJ?
That's PR.
can I get a little side piece with you, Robin?
No, you have to get in line behind Lenny Dykstra.
Well, I'll buy you a dozen roses and cut off all the stems myself.
You know, OJ, you probably would have had a shot with Robin, but your past is kind of a turnoff.
Well, what do you mean? You didn't like the Third Naked Gun movie?
Yeah, I'm not talking about
that. No, it's not your movie career.
You're famous for being violent. That's what we're talking about.
How dare you? I challenge you, Howard, to name three people I've moved.
You had to say three?
Three.
Nice talking to you, OJ.
One last question. What the fuck is a fidget spinner? And can I use it to stab someone?
Alright, we're gonna go, OJ.
Allegedly stab someone.
Alright.
For me, Robin.
Alright.
I got you.
I will pick you up for sushi dinner and get off and hit myself.
Imagine. Robin, you're taking OJ?
Right.
Robin, take a stab at me, Robin, and I will take a stab at you.
Everybody, OJ Simpson, there he is. Thanks, OJ.
Yes, goodbye, OJ. Thank you.
OJ, you killed.
Thanks, man. The juice is loose.
You say bye first.
You want me to say bye first?
Yeah. Bye.
Okay. Bye.
All right. Very good.
Would you have OJ here live in the studio?
Of course. Of course we would. Wouldn't we want to, evidently OJ's been writing jokes in prison for 9 years. Some of that material is just fantastic.
Yeah, I remember they asked him in the hearing if he had addressed his alcohol problem, because alcohol was involved the day he went to those people's rooms to take back his memorabilia.
Yeah.
And he said nobody had ever accused him of having a drinking problem. And he hasn't had a drink in 9 years.
Right.
And, you know, and he hasn't missed it. But they didn't ask him about, you know, his womanizing. Like, he's gotten over that, yeah.
Assuming that we could get OJ, would you want him in the studio? I mean, are we curious to talk to him?
Of course.
Right, yeah. I mean, yeah.
Well, I'm trying to think, who did you say you wouldn't have? Oh, you wouldn't have Mel Gibson.
Yeah.
Who hasn't killed anybody.
Allegedly. Yeah, and I don't know, you know, it's like, I mean, I'd have anyone just to ask me stuff, but who knows? You know what's really weird? We went out on the street and we said to women, And really, we didn't doctor this. This is so fucking upsetting. We said, who would you make love to? Howard Stern or OJ? And I gotta tell you, things just don't go my way. I mean, I am so hideous.
Stop it.
Listen to this. This is
who would be women?
Listen to them.
Who would you rather date? Howard Stern or OJ Simpson?
OJ? OJ Simpson.
Why?
He's cute off.
Oh, Jason. So
why?
Howard Stern is freaky up.
Neither of them. They're both gross.
Can I say neither?
No, gun to your head.
I don't know what to do. Oh, God. Only because I know more about OJ, I guess I would go with OJ.
I would have sex with OJ.
OJ Simpson.
How come?
I don't know.
He's better looking.
Who would you rather date? Howard Stern? Or OJ Simpson.
Those are your choices?
Those are the choices. Gun to your head.
I'd take single.
Gun to your head.
I'll take the bullet.
Wow. Huh? What is it with me?
Do they throw out all the people who
sleep with you?
No. We leave in the ones that say, wait, I couldn't get one nibble.
Not against OJ. Seeing how big he was.
And by the way, I tied the Sandy Hook shooter. Alright, so that's what I'm talking about. Yes, Jake, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, Howard. I just want to tell you that I actually have button-down pants, and they're the greatest thing ever.
Are you gay?
No.
I gotta tell you.
What kind of question is that?
What? Are you gay?
Are you gay?
Why? because I remember I saw this gay movie once where a guy had sailor pants and he unbuttoned them, and this other guy was sucking his cock, and he seemed to enjoy it.
No, the thing is, it's easier to pee. Like, if you want to go pee right away, or hurry up and rip them down.
Rip them down? You gotta unbutton them. The buttons take...
Well, you're not gonna take one by one, and you don't have to do one by one. You just hurry up and just go and rip them right off.
Oh, like yeah, but then your buttons fly off. You can rip them off.
No, they can't rip off with these.
Oh, you mean you pull on the pants and then... Okay.
Right. Yeah. And I don't know.
I have no idea why.
He doesn't know the technique, apparently.
Evidently. And then what about when you have to sit there and button them up? It takes forever.
Not really. I mean, it takes, one second?
I don't know. I hate it. I wish every pants just had zippers. I exclusively wear John Barbados jeans, and like 50% of my jeans have zippers and 50% have button down. And the button downs just look good, and I was like, you know, when I get a pair that looks good, fuck it, I'm buying them. I don't, you know, but that I hate a button down pants. You want to hear a tape of me? Remember the other day I was doing an impression of George Takei?
Yeah.
You know, I do a fairly decent George Takei. I was doing some bit with Robin where I was talking about my Broadway show. I don't even remember what the bit was. It was kind of like, you know, I was just being George Takei. So the guys cut it up and they called a internet radio show, like a gossip kind of show. So this is me as George Takei on a radio show. I think you had talked about that there's going to be a Golden Girls reboot. I don't know.
So, actually, yeah, with George and a couple of other older men.
Yes, and I'm supposed to be in it, aren't I? That's right. And I began to talk about it to you, Rob.
Yeah.
Oh, my.
And what you would do.
Yes. Musculate you. I still wrestle on Sunday night. Did you know that? Guacamole. Do you say guacamole?
Guacamole.
Guacamole. Is that?
Guacamole.
Yes. You know, I get in the shower. I soap up. I come out in my kimono. And then Brad loves to tickle my tits.
Oh, I'm gay.
Anyway, so here I am calling an internet gossip show.
Okay,
it's not bad.
That, you know, it sounds that. It wasn't as good as I think it.
Really? I thought it actually sounded pretty good. That's my opinion of me. I would trust your opinion more. I need you where I got it.
Yeah.
Oh my. I bet you I could fool William Shatner.
Tickle my tits.
Thank you.